Ginsburg. I'm a member of the faculty at Western Illinois University. I'm also a member of the Knox Galesburg Symphony, and I'm the link with all these other fine people here who are my colleagues at Western Illinois University.
I'm Rebecca McGuire. I'm the oboist at Western Illinois University.
Hi, I'm Su Yanko. I am a flute professor at Western Illinois University.
And I'm Natalie Landowski. I'm the piano instructor at Western Illinois University.
First piece we're going to play for you is by Malcolm Arnold. It's a divertimento for flute, oboe, and clarinet. It was written in 1952. It's got six movements. First movement is Allegro Energico. Third movement is Vivace.
Thank you.
movement is Maestoso.
Next piece we'll be playing is three pieces by using both.
Thank you.
the next piece I'll be playing is Etude No. 5, composed by Lee Sang-yoon. Western music was first introduced to Korea in late 800. And when it was introduced in the beginning, every composer took it as it is. Like very vertical and then chord progressions and composed by the rules. But the next generation Korean composers thought they could do something more fun and still not forget about their heritage and their tradition. So they started mixing Korean aesthetics and Western music. So Lee Sang-yoon was the most representative composer from the second generation. And the piece that you're gonna hear from me is the mixture of perfect Korean music aesthetics and Western music, which is very lineal and lots of layered vibrato, which means it starts without the vibrato and then continue with the vibrato towards the end. So hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Next piece is a solo piece for clarinet by Germaine Taillefer. She was a member of Les Six, that group of composers in France, met in Paris, I believe at the Paris Conservatory. They shared a similar approach to composition and were then lumped together as Les Six. We have one other Les Six composer at the end of our program, Darius Milhaud. But the composer I was thinking about when I was studying this piece was Francis Poulenc. Some very interesting similarities. This piece starts off and the Poulenc sonata starts off a lot of tritones, and I thought, aha, she was influenced by Poulenc, and then I realized she wrote this piece 3 or 4 years before he wrote his clarinet sonata, so in fact, I think Poulenc was influenced by Taillefer. It's in three movements. First movement is Allegro Tranquillo. Second is Andante Espressivo. And the fourth is Allegro Brioso.
Thank you.
Our next piece is by Villalobos. He wrote a series of pieces called coros. I'm not sure what the correct pronunciation is. Coros is a Portuguese word that means weeping. And it became associated with a group of Brazilian street musicians who had a very improvisational type of composition. Villalobos, in developing the style of these coros, or choros, said it was a synthesis of native folklore and popular music. This is, I think, his shortest one. Talk to you about our last piece as I very unobtrusively change clarinets back to my B-flat clarinet. Mm-hmm. I guess that was pretty obtrusive. So our second composer from Lacis, Darius Mio, wrote this piece in 1918 in Rio. So another connection to the piece we just played. It's in four movements. The first is tranquillo. My pages are all mixed up. Joyeux, or joy. Emporté, which means carried away. So we finish and we're not here, you'll know what happened. And the last movement is Douloureux, or something to do with sadness. Let me align my pages.
Two pages, right?
I have the
we'll
first.
Go movement by movement.
You're gonna move, yeah, I'm okay for the first movement here.
Okay.
That I'm sure of.